the main class, right, with the topic for today. So pay attention, Javier and everybody, right? I will share right now the presentation. Let me just one sec here. Okay. Okay, I'm sharing right now the presentation. Let me know if you can see the presentation, people. Let me know if you can see it.
Yes, Mr., we can see it.
Oh, okay, perfect. I like it. So we are still here with unit number two, right? And we're talking about different experiences related to marketing and everything, right? So let me move this. This part is dealing with customers, okay? So we're going to be talking today about dealing with customers. So I know that some of you already have a job, right? You have a job already. So you have to deal with customers all the time, yeah? I mean, if you work at a restaurant, if you work in a customer service job, right? So you have to deal with customers. Let me ask you something. Do you think that dealing with customers is easy or difficult? Do you think dealing with customers is easy or difficult? Let me know your answer on the comment section, please. Okay. Let me know your answer in the comment section. Do you think that dealing with customers is easy or difficult? Uh-huh. I think that is difficult, said Kevin Pena. Okay, I like your opinion, Kevin. What about the others? Do you think, I already posted the question on the comment section. Do you think, I'm sorry, I made a mistake there. Okay. Now, yes. Do you think that there are, okay, it says, Jacqueline, sometimes it's difficult. Okay. Javier, I think sometimes could be difficult, but in other opportunities that could be complex. Okay. I agree with you, Javier. And as well, I agree with you, Jacqueline and Kevin. Okay. What about the others? What about the others? Fatima said, I think it is a bit difficult since sometimes we find clients a little complicated. That's right, Fatima. That's right. Okay, somebody else? Somebody else? Okay, let me tell you people about an experience, right? Because I've been working for call centers. Call centers are those places where you usually take calls, okay? You usually take calls from clients. I've been working for American people, United States people, right? And I've been working for Canadians, okay? So let me tell you that when I was working for FedEx, that's a company that delivers packages, right? And they pick up and deliver packages. So in FedEx, I was working, I was taking calls, trying to solve some issues the customers had, okay? And I mean, United States people, I mean, Americans, they are very difficult to deal with. They are very difficult. And I'm gonna say this, I guess, I'm gonna switch to Spanish so you can understand that better, okay? cuando estaba trabajando para esa empresa FedEx y que tenía que hablar con personas allá de Estados Unidos, era bien difícil, porque si no les había llegado un paquete, entonces ellos te decían, hey, pero ¿dónde está mi paquete? Que no sé qué, ¿verdad? Y todo. Entonces, en ese momento, tú tienes que estar haciendo un montón de cosas en la computadora para rastrear dónde está el paquete, para averiguar qué le sucedió al paquete, etc. Y pues, en una ocasión, era una persona que había pedido un vestido de novias. Y lo había pedido desde China. Y no podía llegar el paquete a tiempo porque había un mal clima. Y como había un mal clima, entonces el avión no podía volar. Y ella se iba a casar como que dentro de 2 días, algo así, no me recuerdo bien, dentro de 2 días. Y el paquete no estaba ahí. Entonces, y me estaba así, ¿verdad? Me dijo un montón de cosas. Que por qué, que qué pasaba, que no sé qué, que hiciera lo posible. Pero en esas situaciones, obviamente, no podemos decirle, llamar a la empresa que tiene el paquete y decirle, miren, que vuele el avión, no importa que haya un mal clima, no se puede. Entonces, ahí sí estaba bien difícil. Y lo que yo le dije, mire, hay que esperar y primero Dios, el clima va a mejorar. Y entonces el paquete puede llegar a tiempo. No había de otra. Obviamente me insultó todo, pero no podía hacer nada más. Son cosas imposibles, por así decirlo. Entonces, dealing with customers, dependiendo de la situación, como dijeron ustedes, es difícil. A veces es muy difícil, ¿ya? Aunque también depende mucho de las personas, porque por lo contrario, los canadienses son bastante amables. O sea, cuando estuve trabajando con los canadienses, ellos son súper, súper amables. Incluso aunque pues la empresa esté teniendo un problema con ellos y que la empresa haya sido la del error, ellos son bien amables. Pero bueno, esa es como una experiencia de la que yo he tenido de my service when I'm dealing with customers. Cabal, para que no se pierda la costumbre de que el cliente ha ganado, dice Jacqueline. Sí, entonces, esa es una parte bien difícil. También como teacher, pues, en este caso, si lo vemos de cierta manera, ustedes son los customers, right? Los estudiantes son los customers. O sea, hay que tratar todo trabajo en el que hay que tratar directamente con personas. Es un poco difícil porque las personas a veces solemos ser un poco complicadas, ¿okay? Entonces, ustedes tendrán sus experiencias. Sé que algunos de ustedes trabajan en restaurantes o en otros lados que tendrán sus experiencias no tan agradables, otras experiencias chistosas y otras experiencias agradables con los clientes. Entonces, es bien difícil deal with customers. Ok. Ahora que ya entramos en eso, los contenidos que vamos a estar viendo, los contents o questions, primero le voy a hacer algunas cuantas preguntas. Luego vamos a ver esto de comparatives and superlatives, que eso ya es algo gramatical, hay que ponerle mucha atención. Y luego comparing products and services. A ver, esta parte de acá, no va. Ese es mi error. Aquí olvidé, bueno, lo edité, pero creo que no lo guardé. Entonces, esta parte de ahí no va. I'm sorry for this, ¿ok? Lo que vamos a ver después, vamos a hacer un dialogue, ¿ok? Eso es lo que sigue, vamos a hacer un dialogue de una situación en la que una persona tiene que lidiar con su cliente, ¿ok? Les voy a mostrar un ejemplo, luego ustedes eso es lo que van a hacer como actividad principal, yo les voy a explicar cómo, los requisitos que vamos a seguir, ¿ok? Let's see. Ok, let's move on. Aquí tenemos the first question. The customer is always right. Lo que decía Jacqueline en los comentarios, que eso era para que no se perdiera la costumbre de que el cliente ha ganado. Como ese dicho que dice, the customer is always right. El cliente siempre tiene la razón. ¿Qué creen ustedes? ¿Is the customer always right? Yes or no? Is the customer always right? Yes or no? Yes or not? Give me your answer in the comment section, please. Kevin said, sometimes. Yeah, it depends, right? It depends, Kevin. What about the others? Do you think the customer is always right or not? Yes or not? Mm-hmm. Let me know in the comment section, people. Not always, said Fatima. Very good, Fatima. Mm-hmm. No, said Jacqueline. Okay, yeah, that's true. No, the customer is not always right. Ricardo said no, right? And yeah, I mean, that's reality. The customer is not always right. I mean, sometimes the customer is asking for something impossible, like the example I gave you about the wedding dress. Melissa said no as well. Okay, now, I have this other question here. Let me show you that. What is the customer service like in your country? Okay, we're talking right here about customer service. Okay, customer service. Okay, do you think customer service in El Salvador is good or bad? What do you think? I mean, depending on the situation. It depends on the situation, Ricardo, that's right. But what do you think now? Now, let's talk about this other question. What is customer service like in your country? So is customer service in El Salvador good or bad? What do you think? When you go to a restaurant, when you go to buy something, to a store, what do you think? Is customer service good? Yes or no? In general, right? In general. Mm-hmm. Here in El Salvador, what is your perception about customer service? It's regular. Mm-hmm. Okay, Ricardo said, I'm sorry, Kevin said it is regular. Okay, somebody else, what do you think about customer service? Is it good, bad, regular? What do you think? Mm-hmm. Come on, come on. Not bad, Sir Ricardo. What do you think, Melissa? Is customer service good or bad? Jacqueline said, repeat the question, please. Is customer service in El Salvador good or bad? That's the question, Jacqueline. Fatima said regular. Okay, somebody was speaking there. I couldn't hear you well. Okay, Rosanna, what do you think, Rosanna? Is customer service good or bad in El Salvador? Mm-hmm. Rosanna? Javier, what do you think about customer service in El Salvador?
Okay. Really, I think that it could be depend of the person that is attending to the customer.
Uh-huh.
Podría depender de la persona que están atendiendo, ¿verdad?
Yeah, for sure. It depends, right? It depends on the person. Rosanna said so-so. Okay, very good, Rosanna. It's so-so, right? Yeah, it depends on the situation, right? Sometimes it's good. Yeah, sometimes it is good. It depends on the place as well. Yeah. And do you think, I mean, the customer experience is something important for a company? Yes or no? Do you think the customer's experience is good for the company or not? Mm-hmm. Okay, that's the question. Do you think the customer experience is good for the company? I mean, if the customer has a good experience, is that good for the company or bad for the company? Uh-huh. What do you think? customer experience, is that a good thing or something to care of? For example, if I go to Pollo Campero, right? And the waitress over there, she offers me a good service, right? Good service. So I'm going to be happy. And what happened if I'm happy, right? Remember, I'm the customer. What happened if I'm happy? Okay, if I'm happy with the service at Pollo Campero, I will go to Pollo Campero again, right? And again, and again, and again, once and over, right? So I would continue visiting that place. Why? Because the customer service is good, because the experience is good, right? So that's something very important. Yeah, Kevin, that is important. Jacqueline, it is fundamental for the company because they try to make the customer experience a good one. Very good, Jacqueline. That's right. That's right. So, yeah, I mean, customer service is one of the most important things to take care in a company, okay? So a company should take care of that. Okay, let's continue. Let's move on. Okay, now I got this here. Okay, let's participate. Okay, that one right there is a corner shop, okay? This one right here is a corner or local store. I mean, local store es la tiendita que ustedes tienen en su colonia. Es una local store, okay? O es a corner store, es a corner shop, okay? Esas tienditas son local stores o corner shops, okay? Now, la siguiente ahí, let's see. La siguiente es una designer store, right? Una tienda de diseños. Y la siguiente es una coffee shop. Ok. Diferentes tipos de tienda. Un café. Very good. Now, let's see. Now I have that question there. What is your favorite shop and why? What is your favorite shop and why? Let me know in the comments. If you want, you can turn on your microphone as well and you can say it. If not, post it in the comment section. What is your favorite shop and why? Give me the name of your favorite shop. Mm-hmm. Yeah, people. Favorite shop or restaurant or whatever it is. It doesn't matter, it can be a shop, it can be a restaurant, whatever. Come on.
Disculpe que leo en español, pero no tengo un inglés tan fluido como para decirlo en inglés.
Ok.
Pero con respecto, digamos, estamos hablando de tiendas. Bueno, la pregunta es, ¿cuál es la tienda favorita y por qué, verdad?
Yes, that's right.
Entonces, pero las tiendas está simplemente enfocando a esas, el corner shop, el local store.
No. It can be whatever. I mean, if you tell me, I mean, it can be a coffee shop, right? But you can give me the name. For example, you can say, okay, for example, Kevin said, my favorite shop is coffee shop, right? It's a coffee shop. So you can tell me it's the cafe that is in El Calvario, right? That could be your favorite shop, right? Your favorite store. Or you can tell me maybe, okay, my favorite restaurant, because it can be a restaurant as well. So you can tell me my favorite restaurant is Wendy's or is Pollo Campestre, whatever, right?
Okay, entonces podríamos clasificar las tiendas como toda empresa, digamos, todo local físico que te brindan un servicio o un producto.
Exactly, yes, exactly. So include restaurants and everything, okay? The question right there is, what is your favorite shop? But in this case, in this situation, include restaurants and everything. Okay, Kevin said, because I can eat and drink coffee. That's good, Kevin. Yes, I like coffee as well. Mm-hmm. For example, my favorite restaurant here in Usulután is, I prefer to go to Pollo Campestre, so I'm going to eat pollo, right? But if I mean I have two kind of restaurants, let's call it like that, Pollo Campestre and Wendy's, right? If I don't go to Pollo Campestre, I go to Wendy's, right? Those are like my favorite ones. Javier said my favorite shop is the local store because I can find the most necessary, but I have the opportunity to go to a bigger shop. Let me see. If I have the opportunity to go to a bigger shop, that is more interesting because there are variety of products. Okay, very good. Javier, Fatima, my favorite clothing store is Cool Fashion Store. I like it because its clothes are fine and it has different brands and I like their way of attention. Okay, you mean Fatima, you like their customer service, right? You like their customer service. Le gusta el customer service que le ofrecen ahí. Muy bien. Okay, fashion store. That's a good shop. Mm-hmm. Okay. Ahí va el carrito de la verdura. Esperemos que pase. Pueden estar contando
su favorite shop.
Pueden postear su respuesta mientras tanto.
Ahí van los tomates ya.
Ahí van el chile, la cebolla, el tomate, el pepino. Ropa lejía.
Es de mi tienda favorita.
El carrito ese.
¿Podría anunciar los productos que vende ese carro en inglés usted, licenciado, para obtener, utilizarlo como una estrategia, aunque nadie le podría entender?
Like a strategy. it got tomatoes. We got potatoes. They got pineapples. They got sugar, they said. They got, what else? They got chili. They got peppers. They got, no me acuerdo qué más llevaba.
Le falta practicar, no tiene la esencia todavía de...
Para vender. Sí, es que me acuerdo de las verduras, pero creo que mencionó otros productos también. Okay, there you go. So, let's continue then. That's your favorite. It says, Ricardo said, my favorite store is coffee because I like to talk and consume the products. Okay, very good. So you like to go to the coffee shop, Ricardo. That's good. And how often you go there? For example, let me ask you, let's see. Da, da, da. Okay, Kevin, how often do you go to the coffee shop? How often? How often quiere decir que tan a menudo, okay? Puede, la respuesta puede ser once a day, que sería una vez al día. Puede ser twice a day, que serían dos veces al día, que no creo. O también podrían decir I go three times a week, que serían tres veces a la semana. Digo three times y luego digo a week. O pueden decir solo one time a week. O pueden decir five times a week, que cinco veces a la semana. O si quieren decirlo en el mes, solo dicen I go once a month, or I go two times a month, or twice a month, or así sucesivamente, right? There you go.
I go once a month.
Once a month, una vez al mes, very good.
Or once a week.
Or once a week, very good.
Depends.
It depends. Okay, for example, I told you at the beginning that I usually go to Pollo Campestre and Wendy's, right? So I go to Pollo Campestre around five times a month, I guess. And I go to Wendy's around Yeah, 5 times a month as well. Yeah. Mm-hmm. What about you, Fatima? How often do you go to Cool Fashion Store? How often? Mm-hmm.
¿Cómo es para decir como dos o tres veces en el año, Lick? ¿Cómo sería?
Twice or 3 times a year. Ahí sería a year. Twice or 3 times a year. Twice quiere decir dos. Luego ya de tres en adelante dice 3 times, 4 times, 5 times. Para decir una se dice once. Para decir dos se diría twice. Ya de tres en adelante se dice el número. Se dice 3 times, 4 times, 5 times, etc. Y luego, si usted quiere decir que va 3 veces al día, dice a day. Si es a la semana, dice a week. Si es al mes, dice a month. Y si es al año, dice a year. ¿Ok? Vaya.
A year. Okay.
Le voy a preguntar otra vez y lo dice así, seguido. How often do you go to Cool Fashion Store? Uh-huh. I go. No le pudimos escuchar, Pati. Hello, Fátima.
Twice.
Okay, twice or 3 times a year. Okay, very good, Fatima. Thank you. Let me see. Okay, Ricardo, you said your favorite store is coffee, the coffee shop, right? Ricardo, how often do you go there to the coffee shop?
Me confundí un poco en esa parte, pero no sé si sería I go 3 times a month.
3 times a month, 3 veces al mes.
Sí.
Perfecto.
Está bien.
Así es. Sí.
Okay.
Let's see. Javier, your favorite shop is the local store, you said, right? How often do you go to your local store, Javier? Mm-hmm. Javier? Hello. Hello. Oh, you're doing something. Okay, let's see. Okay.
Perdimos a Javier.
Yeah, we lost him. He posted on the comment section. Wait, I don't know what he's doing something, I guess. Okay, let's continue. And let me ask you now, what do you like to buy there in your local store? What do you like to buy? Mm-hmm. So what do you like to buy? Es como que es lo que le gusta comprar. For example, in my case, I like to go to Pollo Campestre and I like to eat chicken, right? I like chicken from Pollo Campestre. And when I go to Wendy's, I usually buy a crispy hamburger or a meat hamburger. That's it. That's what I usually buy when I go to those places. Right. What do you usually buy when you go to your favorite shop? I mean, probably you buy coffee or and a piece of cake. I don't know. You buy shirts, blouses, what else? A dress, maybe jeans. I don't know. Right. So what do you buy when you go to your favorite shop?
I can answer.
Yeah.
I like to buy coffee, a sandwich, or croissant.
Okay, very good. Very good, Kevin.
I like to buy Subway pizza and coffee.
Very good. Subway pizza and coffee. Nice. Okay, somebody else?
Okay, hello, Mr. Okay, I'm going to answer to the before question and also to the present
okay.
question. I go to maybe three times a month to the local store. And what do you like to buy there? Okay, I want to tell you that I have a small barbershop, so I need some product. For that reason, I go to the local store and I buy different kind of product. For example, blades that I need to do my
your house
job.
Okay, your job. Very good, Javier. Yeah. I like it. Very good, sir. Okay. Ahorita no, la sesión se va a cerrar. La voy a cerrar yo y volvemos a entrar rapidito, Chris. Ya solo pasamos a otra parte y luego les explico la actividad y eso es todo, ¿ok? Se conectan al instante, please.